Okay, so the directions are to graph the following lines. They're given in standard form. Standard form looks like this: AX plus BY equals C, where A, B, and C are real numbers. Okay, so my example number one, 2X minus 4Y equals 8. That's a line. We're going to have to graph this line. Okay, so we're going to work with really two forms in this class, this standard form and slope-intercept form. So let me just show you slope-intercept form. This is going to be the next chapter, but let me just show you what it is, because you're probably familiar with it. Slope-intercept looks like this: y equals mx plus b. Remember that? Probably seen that before, where m is the slope of the line and b is the intercept. Okay, this is next chapter. We're not going to do this yet, but I just want to show you that we'll deal with lines in a couple different ways. Okay, m is the slope, b is the y-intercept. Okay, so let me just do that, because we're not going to do that yet. That's next chapter. Okay, this chapter, standard form. So you notice the difference. In this case, x and y are on the same side of the equation. Over here, y is all by itself. Okay, so first standard form. So here's how we're going to graph it. We're not going to identify the slope, but we are going to find both intercepts, the x and y intercept. So what we're going to do in number one is find two points on this line, two special points, the intercepts, x and y intercepts. Okay, so I'm going to draw this little chart just to organize my work. I'm going to put a 0 in for x, 0 for y to get started. This gives me a little guidance. Okay, so what I'm going to do is find the y intercept. The x value of the y intercept is 0. Alright, so what I'm going to do is take this 0 and plug it in for x and figure out what y is when x is 0. Okay, so literally plug in 0 for x, and then solve for y. So I plug in the 0 for x, which is easy because that goes away, right? I'm left with just negative 4y equals 8. So I know what to do with the algebra steps here, because we've done it before, to solve for y, divide by negative 4. So y equals 8 divided by negative 4, negative 2. Okay, that's just one point now. When x is 0, y is negative 2. Okay, this is still the line we're dealing with. There's a bunch of points on this line. We're just finding two of them right now. Okay? So now, what do I do? I find the other point. Draw a little separation here. Okay, now I find out what x is when y is 0. This is the other intercept. Alright? So, I'm going to go ahead and do that work. Let's see, right here. I'm going to plug in 2x minus 4y, where y is 0. So now I plug the 0 in for y. Do it all over again. Equals 8. 4 times 0 is 0. That's gone. So that just leaves me with 2x equals 8. Divide by 2 to get my solution. X equals 4. Okay. So notice there's two points here. 0, negative 2. Alright, I'm going to graph that. That's right here. And 4, 0. Graph that. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is why we plotted those points earlier, so I could graph those. Okay, there's a lot of other points I could find, but I found the two ones that I consider the easiest, the intercepts. And now I graph a line through these two points, okay? And that's my answer. That line that goes on in both directions forever. Alright, not too bad, right? Let's try another one. Okay, again, when we get to the final, it'll just say graph a line, and some lines will be in this standard form, what I call standard form, and some will be in slope intercepts. That's the first thing we need to recognize. Right now, it's just everything's in standard form. But when I do see something in standard form, I'm just going to draw my chart, right, and graph by intercepts. Okay, so same process. I'm going to find the y-intercept by plugging in x equals 0, and I'm going to do it all over again except plug in 0 for y. Okay. Again, why do I choose 0? I choose 0 because it's easy. Plug in 0 for x, look what happens. That whole x term goes away. So I just have 3y equals 9 divided by 3, and I get y equals 3. Alright, so when x is 0, y is 3, that goes here. And now I do it all over again. I plug in 0. Try that again. Plug in 0 for y. X plus 3 times 0. Get a little separation here. Equals 9. That's gone, and this just leaves me with x equals 9. Okay, so that's over here, 0, 3, 9, 0. 0, 3 is right here, that's one point. 9, 0, I just realized I'm going to need more graph here, so let's see if I can't come up with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, it's about right out here. I just realized I'm out of room. Okay, but that's where it would be. Okay, so that's the point 9, 0. So now go ahead and draw a line through those two points. Something like that. Okay? Alright, so one more video with two more examples coming up next. Examples